Let's continue our discussion about red blood cells. So, and investigations. We have seen what is meant by packed cell volume, hemoglobin concentration, and red cell count. Once you know these three basic values in a given patient, that for a given patient, what are these three values, basic values, then you can derive what is the volume of one RBC. That is mean corpuscular volume. What is the concept of mean corpuscular volume? The average volume of, mean volume of one red blood cell. Then mean corpuscular hemoglobin. What is the amount of hemoglobin in each RBC? And then mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration. What is the concentration of hemoglobin in a given RBC? I will explain these things. But all these are derived concepts from first three. I will explain how. We go to the first initial readings and then we'll move forward. This was our patient. This is the total amount of blood. Here it was packed cell volume, and we said packed cell volume is how much? Yes, 0.45. And then in this person, of course, this is all, what is this? Red blood cell. So packed cell volume is occupied by certain number of red blood cell. So we also talked about red cell count. That was 5 million per ml. Is that right? Then we talked about hemoglobin concentration. You remember? Now we said, for in this total unit of blood, packed cell volume was 0.45. Every ml was containing 5 million RBCs, and hemoglobin which was packed in these RBCs, that was making what percentage? 15 percent. So that was what hemoglobin concentration, that is in this case 15%. Is that right? If it is 1 liter blood, then it will be 150 grams. If it is 100 ml blood, then hemoglobin will be 15 grams. Is that right? Depending upon what is the total amount. Are you clear? These are our basic values. But now we want to develop a concept of mean corpuscular volume. This mean is not that mean which you talk about your friend. This mean is not mean RBCs. This is actually average. Average volume occupied by one cell. It is so easy to determine. If I say that you have these three values, you can make this, you can derive this value. How? Mean corpuscular volume is the total volume divided by the total number. Is it difficult? It's so easy. That total volume occupied by the all RBCs divided by the number of RBCs will give you the volume occupied by one RBC. Is it difficult? So that is such an easy calculation. Mean corpuscular volume is total volume. What is total volume? Packed cell volume divided by red cell count. Do you think it really need to be understood? It's so easy. Right? So actually, when we talk about packed cell volume, and if we know the number of red cell count, right? If total packed cell volume divided by total number of red blood cell, the result will be what? Mean corpuscular volume. Now, packed cell volume was how much? 0.45. And red cell count was 5 millions. Right? When you correct the unit, it will become 90 into 10 to the raised power minus 15 liter. Oh my God. One RBC is very small. For example, if this is point, if it is 1 ml blood, listen carefully, if it is 1 ml blood, then total packed cell volume will be 0.45 ml. 0.45 ml divided by 5 millions, the result will be very large or very small? Very small. So it will become 19 to 10 to the raised power minus 15 liters. You know, you talk about liter, then you talk about deciliter, then you talk about milliliter, then you talk about small. It is so small, the special term which is used is, for this situation, femtoliter. As there are milliliter, there are femtoliter. So what we say that mean corpuscular volume is approximately 90 femtoliter. What is this? This is the volume of one RBC. How did we get it? Packed cell volume or hematocrit divided by number of RBCs. You get the volume per RBC. Is it difficult? No. So it is very easy. That 45 divided by 5 is somewhere around 9. But they correct all the, what is this, units on those sides. The end result will be 90. So if next time someone asks you, in a normal healthy person, packed cell volume is 0.45. Red cell count is 5 million per ml. Hemoglobin is 15%. And what is MCV? MCV mean? Volume of one RBC. That should be around 90 femtoliters. Is that right? Okay. Then someone asks, okay, 90 is the volume of one RBC. I'm talking about this RBC. Okay, this specific RBC is 90 femtoliter. Is that right? This is the volume of this RBC. Now another man comes. He says, no, I'm not interested in volume. I want to know what is the amount of hemoglobin in every RBC in this case. This specific patient, what is the amount of hemoglobin per RBC? Again, if you have the basic values, you can derive it. You put, what you will put? If you want to know mean corpuscular hemoglobin, hemoglobin present in one corpuscle. Now we are talking about the amount of hemoglobin. We are not talking about the volume of red blood cells. We have already knew that a healthy RBC has, what is the volume of healthy RBC? 90 femtoliters. Now we want to know it a healthy RBC, what is the amount of hemoglobin? You say, okay, let's calculate it. It's very easy. Total amount of hemoglobin divided by the number of RBCs. Is it difficult? It's easy. And you already know total amount of hemoglobin is 15%. If it is 100 ml, then you know it is 15 gram. If it is 1 ml, then it is, of course, less. So let's suppose this is what? Total hemoglobin in a given volume, total hemoglobin, that is of course hemoglobin concentration divided by red cell count, and you will get amount of hemoglobin per RBC. Is it difficult? Claro? Clear? Okay. So what you will do, hemoglobin is 15, suppose, percent, red cell is, oh my God, 5 millions. Do you think hemoglobin, if, let's suppose, if we have 100 ml blood, in 100 ml blood, hemoglobin is only 15 grams. In 100 ml of the blood, hemoglobin is only 15 gram. And this 15 gram is divided by how many millions? In 1 ml, there are 5 millions. In 100 ml, there are 500 millions. When you will divide 15 gram by 500 millions of RBCs, you will get the hemoglobin per RBC. That is, will be a large amount in kilograms or very small units. Very small unit. That is in picograms. So 15 divided by 5 is 3. So actually it is 30 pico gram. Now, from original three values, we are deriving the red cell indices. What are red cell indices? Values with one RBC, which are derived units. Mean corpuscular volume is the volume of one RBC. How did you get it? Total volume, hematocrit or packed cell volume divided by total number. Then we came to mean corpuscular hemoglobin. Total hemoglobin divided by number of RBCs. MCV is normally how much? About 90 femtoliter. And MCH is how much? 30 picogram. Is it clear? Now someone says, okay, this is the volume of RBC, this is the hemoglobin present in each RBC. He says, can you derive what is the hemoglobin concentration per RBC? Now, amount of hemoglobin per RBC is different. Concentration of hemoglobin per RBC is slightly different concept. Let me tell you. Let's suppose this is a bag. This is a bag of 90 units. Total capacity is 90 units. And how much hemoglobin it has? 30 units. Do you think it's 100% full, 50% full, or how much full? If you have a bag, RBC bag, the volume of bag, which is maximum volume, is how much? 90 units. And it is full how much? 30 units. Is that right? So what do you think hemoglobin concentration in this bag, which has a capacity of 90 and loaded with 30 units, what is the percentage of loading? 33%. It's one third full, because we can imagine if it was 100, then it should be 33. I think it's basic mathematics, primary school. Is that right? So this concept, that what is the volume of one RBC, what is the amount of hemoglobin per RBC, and what is the degree of hemoglobinization, hemoglobin concentration, that is mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration. Mean corpuscular hemoglobin, yes, concentration. And this mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration can be determined by total hemoglobin. Yes, that is hemoglobin concentration, by total volume. Look now, please, carefully. When we'll talk about hemoglobin, amount of hemoglobin per RBC, then total hemoglobin divided by number of red blood cells. When we talk about the concentration of hemoglobin in a given RBC, total hemoglobin is now not divided by the number of RBC, total hemoglobin is divided by total volume of the RBC. So that we know how, what is the degree of filling of RBC volume by the hemoglobin. What is the degree of hemoglobinization, right? So naturally in this case, what is the total hemoglobin? 15. What is the total volume? 0.45. When you will correct everything, it will become how much? 33%. Am I clear? Any problem into this? So next time when you are doing some patient's study on the red blood cells, first of all you should look in the blood report, what is the packed hematocrit. That will give you packed cell volume. You must know what is the hemoglobin percentage concentration. That is the, now packed cell volume is the total volume by all the RBCs in a given amount of blood. This is the total hemoglobin per unit of blood. This is the total number of RBCs in a unit of blood. But when you come to the derived values, these are called red cell indices. Mean corpuscular volume is volume of one RBC. So total volume divided by red cell count. Total volume divided by red cell count. Mean corpuscular volume. Mean corpuscular hemoglobin. Total hemoglobin divided by red cell count. Mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration. Total hemoglobin divided by total volume. Am I clear? Now let me make it even more clear, because now I will correlate all these concepts we have gone up to this. Is that right? I will correlate all these concepts basically with microcytic, normocytic, macrocytic, and normochromic, hyperchromic, and hyperchromic cells. Now we'll put these figures in terms in context of these terms, right? Let's come and discuss it separately. I will go back to my studies. We'll just rapidly review what we have done. We said we have a patient with the blood and his packed cell volume was how much rapidly? It's a healthy, suppose as far as blood findings are, they are normal. So packed cell volume is 0.45. Red cell count is 5 million per ml. And what was the third thing? Hemoglobin concentration was 15%. Is that right? Then we made the derivatives for one RBC. I will draw that single RBC here, right? This is that single RBC which we were talking about, right? Now this single RBC, I've made a section of that, right? Normally, you know, the size of the RBC is about 7.5 microns. But I'm not talking about the size of the disc of RBC. I'm talking about, first of all, the volume occupied by one RBC. Now, you will tell me the values. Mean corpuscular volume. What was the normal in that person? 90 femtoliter. Is that right? Mean corpuscular hemoglobin. How much was that? 30 picogram, we have already derived. Is that right? The same person. Mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration, how much was that? 33%. The degree of juiciness is 33%. Is that right? I'm talking about red blood cell juice, hemoglobin, right? You are laughing in a very suspicious way. Okay, now listen. Now, there is one situation. Red cell volume is more and it is overfilled or underfilled. It is 33% full. It is a big bag with less filling. It, for example, if 90 unit of volume is full of 90 picogram, RBC will be full. And if you put so much hemoglobin in one RBC artificially, RBC will become globular. You are understanding? You can imagine females have, you know, Carthera bags. If they are underfilled, they are pressed. But they are overfilled, they become like globular. Same is true about RBCs. RBCs are normally 100% full or 33% full of hemoglobin. 33%. So there are, now, normal filling of RBC is 33%. It means that their total volume is more and amount of hemoglobin is far less. Due to that reason, it cannot be a swollen cell. It is rather bigger volume with underfilled. So it is biconcave disc. Now, I'm showing here normal hemoglobinization. Now what happens? Because red blood cells are passing through narrow capillaries. They are pressed from many angles. So because they fold on each other, usually hemoglobin in the center is less than on the sides is more. You understand it? Now this is the volume of RBC shown. And what is this inside? Amount of hemoglobin shown in this diagram. This is the volume I'm showing. And this is what I'm showing. Amount of hemoglobin. Now, when such red blood cell is seen under the microscope, if you make a blood film and look at such red blood cell, do you think it is evenly full? No, it is more full on the periphery and less full in center. So hemoglobin is which color?
Red.
Thank you for knowing it. He knows that it is red color. Good. He knows that hemoglobin is red colored. And he also knows hemoglobin is more on the periphery of the blood and less in the center. So red color will be more on the periphery or more in the center? Periphery. That is why normal red blood cells are, yes, having central paler. Why they are centrally pale and more pink on the side? Because volume is more and hemoglobin is less. About one third of the red blood cell is full of hemoglobin. Due to this reason, because it twists and turns into vessels, especially small capillaries, so hemoglobin goes more on the periphery and less in the center. So this is the normal situation. The normal red blood cell, if we look from the top, this is red blood cell. You will see, what is that? It's degree of hemoglobinization. So central one third is, the central one third is pale as compared to the outer two third. Is that right? This is the normal shade of red blood cell. If it is normally filled, how much should be the pallor? Central one third area. Is that right? Now, such red blood cell is said to be of normal color. And when it is normal color, we call it normochromic. What we call it, this red blood cell? Normochromic. And so, this red blood cell, which is having this volume, this amount of hemoglobin, and this is the hemoglobin concentration, its appearance is one third pallor. This is of normal volume and normal degree of hemoglobinization. When it is normal volume, normal size, we say it is normocytic. And when it is normal color, due to normal degree of hemoglobinization, we say it is normochromic. So this red blood cell is what you will call it? Yes, normocytic, normocytic, normochromic. So next time, if you look at the blood report and it is written that it is normocytic, normochromic blood film in the RBC, it means volume of the RBC is normal and degree of hemoglobinization is normal. Or you can say MCB is normal and MCHC is normal. Any problem here? Now, let's make some variations from here. Due to some disease processes, there can be certain variations. Here I'm putting normal sized 3 RBCs. These are normal sized. Three RBCs, right? So all of them are normocytic. For example, in all of them, mean corpuscular volume is 90 femtoliter. Is that right? Mean corpuscular volume is 90 femtoliter. This is from another patient and mean corpuscular volume is 90 femtoliter. So all of them are normocytic. Right? Here, hemoglobin per RBC is, mean corpuscular hemoglobin is 30 picogram. Then mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration will be, yes, mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration will be 33%. So how would you comment on this RBC? Normochromic? Normochromic? Normocytic. Now we take RBC from another person. Here mean corpuscular volume is same as above, but mean corpuscular hemoglobin is 15 picogram and mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration is how much? Okay, let's put it 20 picogram. Now look, what is the difference in first and the second? Both of them have same volume, but it has 30 picogram hemoglobin and this has 20 picograms. So the lower one is underfilled. Is that right? It was how much filled? 33%. It is how much filled? If it is 20, it is 22% almost. Is that right? 23% or 22%. It is 22% MCHC. Now, this is more juicy as compared to upper or less juicy? Less juicy. So it will be more pink or less pink? Less pink. Even though both of them have same size, but here juice was more, here juice is less. Juice means hemoglobin here. Let me remind you. Right? Now, because it is underfilled, here you will see the degree of pallor will be increased or decreased in the center?
Increased.
Increased. No, look. Total amount of hemoglobin here, it is less. It was 33% hemoglobinized. It is almost 20% or 22% hemoglobinized. So it has less hemoglobin. So more hemoglobin will go in the periphery, and as compared to the upper, it will have very little in the center. So central pallor will become larger. Are you understanding? Right? So it will look like this. As compared to the upper one. You are understanding? It is pink in very periphery. Here it is pink in larger periphery. So when you will look at it, when you look at upper RBC and then lower RBC, both of them look of the same size. It is normocytic. This is also normocytic. But it is normochromic. It is? Hypochromic. Its color is less. What is it? It is hypochromic. So I will write here. The upper one was what? Normocytic and normochromic. Is that right? The upper one. And what is this? Yes, normocytic and hypochromic. RBC. Is that clear? Now we imagine another RBC in which mean corpuscular volume is 90 femtoliter. It is, I'm telling hypothetically, because normally RBC cannot be overfilled. But hypothetically, we talk about this RBC. Mean corpuscular volume is, you like the hypothetical things or not? Young men like too much. Yes, I know. Mean corpuscular volume is 90%, 90 femtoliter. Mean corpuscular hemoglobin is, let's suppose, 45 picogram. What is the mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration, my friends? 50%. Yeah. It is over juicy. It will get too much juice. So maybe it is so much rich in, what is this, hemoglobin, that even in the center, even though here also there's more hemoglobin on the sides, but even center is very well filled. So you may not find there is any, you may find central pallor is very, very small or almost disappears. So we'll call this cell normocytic. Yes, hyperchromic. Normocytic. Yes, hyperchromic. So by this concept, what I wanted to tell you, that whenever we talk about mean corpuscular volume, we are talking about that it is normocytic or not. And whenever we are talking about MCHC, we are talking about, is it normochromic or not? Is that right? Now there is one thing. Normally, doctors say that normal value of mean corpuscular volume should be 90 femtoliter plus negative 8. What does it mean? Okay, you put it plus negative 10. It is a normal, of course, femtoliter. What does it mean? That normal RBC can be maximum 90 plus 10 or 90 minus 10. So if RBC is larger, rather than 90 femtoliter, it is 95 femtoliter, 98 femtoliter, it is still normal. Or if it is slightly smaller than the 90, for example, your red blood cell is 86 femtoliter, it is still normal. But they say when it is more than, okay, when it is more than 100 femtoliter, take it as macrocytic cell, macrocytosis, macrocytosis, when your RBCs are larger than, when your mean corpuscular volume is more than 100. Or if in your patient, if RBCs are having mean corpuscular volume less than 80 femtoliter, we say there is microcytosis. So when we say your patient is displaying microcytosis, it means mean corpuscular volume is less than 80. Or if you look at a report and mean corpuscular volume is 60, of course there is microcytosis. You look at another blood report and mean corpuscular volume, MCV, is 110, patient has macrocytosis. Is that clear? Now, let's talk about microcytosis. Of course, these are smaller RBCs or larger? These are smaller . Now look, what really happens here, mean corpuscular volume is suppose 50 femtoliter, 60 femtoliter. If this RBC has mean corpuscular volume of how much? 60 femtoliter. It is of course microcytic. And hemoglobin is, amount of hemoglobin, mean corpuscular hemoglobin is 20 picogram. It means volume is reduced as well as amount of hemoglobin is reduced. But what is the mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration? Mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration 33%. So juiciness is okay. It's a smaller orange, the smaller amount of juice, but size is reduced in proportion with the juice, in the same proportion. So what we will say that it is, even though microcytic, but it is normochromic. So even the smaller, but still in smaller . So it is, what is it? It is microcytic, normochromic. Is that right? Because MCV is less than normal, but MCHC is normal. Am I clear? I'm surprised. You are really understanding it?
Yes,
all of you? Great. I'm dealing with very intelligent bunch of doctors. Okay. Now this is another microcyte, because here I say it is mean corpuscular volume is again 60 femtoliter. Mean corpuscular hemoglobin here is 15 picogram. Mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration is 25%. It is under hemoglobinized or over? Under hemoglobinized. So what does it mean? Even though RBC is small, but hemoglobin is too small. So it is under too, it is very less juicy. Not only it is small, even juice is also too less. So it will become like this. And so what is it now? Microcytic hypochromic. What is it? It was, upper one was microcytic normochromic. This is microcytic, yes, hypochromic. Now we imagine another situation. There is an RBC, when it was produced, it was absolutely normal. When this RBC was produced by the bone marrow, it was absolutely normal. But its membrane had some structural defect. And when this RBC was twisting and turning through narrow capillaries, some of its membrane was lost. So as it passes through circulation, progressively its membrane keep on losing, its volume will keep on reducing. Its volume will keep on reducing. So this is an RBC which was originally, mean corpuscular volume was originally 90 femtoliter. But because it has some defect in its membrane structure, this disease is called spherocytosis. What happens in spherocytosis, that membranes, I will explain in detail later, for a while you just trust me, that what happens in spherocytosis, that RBC's membranes are lost when they are passing through narrow capillaries. Membrane structure is not properly anchored with the substance of RBCs. Those proteins which make a network and support the membrane, those proteins are defective. Just imagine there's a lady who is recently married, you know, they put a lot of ropa, lot of extra dress and elegantly walk, right? But just imagine if she's passing through narrow tunnel, then progressively piece of the dress is lost. In the end, what will happen? She is trying to hide herself in a very small dress. She will become spherical. Same happens with RBC. Originally, it is having a lot of extra membrane. You are understanding? But when this RBC is passing through the different capillaries, losing its membrane, like equal losing the pieces of dress and progressively shrinking, trying to adjust in a larger lady in a smaller dress, what will happen? It will become something like circular, not elegant. Is that right? Same thing happened with RBC. That RBC, which was originally like this, normal shape, and let's suppose its hemoglobin was also, what was this? Normal amount. As this RBC was passing through the different capillaries, it lost the membrane but did not lose the hemoglobin. So eventually mean corpuscular volume is reduced. Rather than mean corpuscular volume of 90, eventually it becomes 60 femtoliter. But mean corpuscular hemoglobin remained the same. What was original? Original was mean corpuscular volume was, what was the original mean corpuscular volume? 90. What was mean corpuscular hemoglobin normal? Yes?
30.
Israel, please magnify it when I'm writing it. 30. Right? And what was normal mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration? 33%. Is that right? Now, after traveling through capillaries, as it lost its membrane, mean corpuscular volume rather than 90 became 60. Mean corpuscular hemoglobin, which was originally 30, is still 30 picogram. But mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration is 50%. So it become under hemoglobinized, over hemoglobinized. It is over hemoglobinized. So what will happen? That even in the center, when hemoglobin will become too much, it swell up. And from the sides, membrane has been removed. So it become almost a what? Sphere. You are understanding? It becomes almost a sphere. Do you think you will find any central pallor there? It's a like a spherical RBC, because lost the membrane and hemoglobin is normal, but membrane is less than normal, so it becomes spherical structure. Is that right? So when you look at this RBC, will you find central pallor? No. So when you look this RBC from the top, let's compare all these. There's one RBC here, there's another RBC here, this is another RBC here. In this RBC, central pallor is 1/3. What is it? 1/3. It is normochromic. Central pallor is very large. What is this? This RBC is hypochromic. And here, you don't see any central pallor. What is this? Hyperchromic. So what is this RBC? Microcytic hyperchromic. What is this RBC? Microcytic hyperchromic. Now we come to another side and discuss. These are larger RBCs. These are three RBCs which are larger than normal. It means their mean corpuscular volume is, yes, I'll put it here. Mean corpuscular volume is, suppose 120 what? Femtoliter. So it is macrocytic. Here also mean corpuscular volume is 120 femtoliter. Here mean corpuscular volume is also 120 femtoliter. So So all these three RBCs are macrocyte. But we talk about hemoglobin. Here mean corpuscular hemoglobin is 40 picogram. Here mean corpuscular hemoglobin is 30 picogram. Here mean corpuscular hemoglobin is 60 picogram. It means here in first case where MCV is 120 and MCH is 40, mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration is 33%. In second case, mean corpuscular volume is 120, mean corpuscular hemoglobin is 30, so mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration is 25%. And here, mean corpuscular volume is 120 and mean corpuscular hemoglobin is 60, so mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration is 50%. So all of them are macrocyte. This is macrocyte with normal degree of hemoglobinization. With normal degree of hemoglobinization. So it will have central pallor for how much? 1/3. So what is this RBC? You will tell me now. Macrocytic. Yeah, macrocytic. Normochromic. Now you will tell me about this red blood cell. That this red blood cell is under hemoglobinized. So what will be it? What is that? Macrocytic hypochromic. That's great. Hypochromic. And what about this RBC? It is over hemoglobinized. What is that? Macrocytic hyperchromic. Even though we don't come across these cells, but this is just hypothetically to tell how to develop a concept related with these terms, hyperchromic. Am I really clear to all of you? Okay, I will make a test to you now. And I will see if you have really understood or not. If you have really understood, then we'll stop the lecture. Let's suppose I put different reports here, blood reports. Report number 1, mean corpuscular volume is 90 femtoliter, mean corpuscular hemoglobin is 30 picogram, mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration is 33%. What is your conclusion? Yes? Normocytic. Normochromic. Good. RBCs. We cannot tell it is anemia or not. Because for anemia, we have to see total hemoglobin is normal or less. If we have to determine it is anemia, then total hemoglobin should be less than normal values. And total packed cell volume should be less than normal. But for a while, we can say by these three figures, we can only tell this red blood cell is normocytic, normochromic. Now I will give you the values and you have to tell me rapidly. Mean corpuscular volume is 120 femtoliter. Mean corpuscular hemoglobin is 40 picogram. And mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration is 33%. What is that? Macrocytic. Very good. Macrocytic. Normochromic. Okay, let's put one more value. Mean corpuscular volume is 60 femtoliter. Mean corpuscular hemoglobin is 30 picogram. Mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration is 50%. What is it? Yes, microcytic hypochromic. Microcytic. You have done how many mistakes? Hyper? Okay, hyperchromic. You have done how many mistakes? No mistake up to now. Okay, now we see what happened. There's another report come to you. mean corpuscular volume is 120 femtoliter. Mean corpuscular hemoglobin is 30 picogram, and mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration is 25%. What is it? Macrocytic hypochromic. Good. And if we come to the, we'll make total 6 studies. If you can do all of them, I'll be really impressed by you. There's another patient, mean corpuscular volume. Now, you know, mentally you attuned, because you are not a doctor. You are thinking, according to this result, I can make some judgment. Okay, mean corpuscular volume is 60 femtoliter. What is your judgment now? Microcytic. Mean corpuscular hemoglobin is 15 picogram. What is your judgment now? It is a small RBC with small amount of hemoglobin. But what is the ratio? MCHC. What is that? 25%. So what is your judgment, final judgment, by combining this information? This patient has problem microcytosis or microcytic hypochromic situation. Hypochromic. Is that right? Now I'll put, and you have to rapidly tell me. Mean corpuscular volume is 90 femtoliter. Mean corpuscular hemoglobin is 30 picogram. Mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration is 33%. What is the situation? Rapido. Normocytic. Normochromic. Excellent. You have done all of them perfectly. Okay. So at least clap for yourself. Yes, strongly. Yes, very good. Excellent. Right? Now we do the last thing, which I did not discuss. I have discussed all these things. We have not discussed red cell distribution width, but we have talked about microcytosis, normocytic, macrocytic, normochromic, hypochromic, hyperchromic. Can you integrate all this information, how it is linked with each other? In the end, red cell distributive width is actually a concept related with variation in the size of red blood cells. Sometimes what happens, for example, a patient has microcytic RBCs, and you give him blood transfusion of normal blood. So normal blood transfusion is containing normocytic cells, and previously cells were microcytic. So he will have two types of RBCs, microcyte as well as normocyte. So what will happen there? That the variation in the size of RBC has significantly widened. Variation in the size of the RBC has been significantly widened. Let me explain, you look confused. Okay, I will make a distribution curve. Most of the distribution curve are bell shaped in the nature. Let me tell you, we talk about the colors of people. If you go to some Asian country, all of them have almost which color?
Yellow.
Somewhat yellow color. Okay, you go to China. You go to India, they are somewhat yellowish brown color. In most of the people, suppose here you put yellow brown color, here you put very white, and here you put very black. In Indian population, is that right? The people who are very brownish color, most of their percentage is very high. Most of the people fall into this category. Those people which are very light color, they are very less. And people who are very dark color, they are very less. Is that right? This is normal curve of the distribution of color in this population. Now you go to another population where black and white people are living in a mixed population. Now you put it here, relatively white color, relatively black color. But curve will become somewhat like this. You know why? In the white, there will be very, very white, average white, and less white people. And within the black, there will be less black, black, and very black people. So total, it has widened or shrunken?
Widened.
Now you imagine RBCs. In a healthy person, most of the RBCs are normocytic. we put here percentage of number of RBCs, and here we put the MCV. Here we put MCV, normal MCV is 90 femtoliter. Most of the RBCs are around 90 femtoliter. In a healthy person, RBCs which are very small are very less, and RBCs which are very large are very less. But let's suppose person has microcytosis, microcytic situation. Then here it will be 60 femtoliter. So originally he has most of the RBCs 60 femtoliter. So very few RBCs less than 60, very few more than 60. But when you put blood transfusion, the new population of RBCs come with 90 femtoliter. Is that right? And there are very few which are near to the 60 and very few which are near to the 100. You're understanding? But now because there are two types of size of the RBC, microcytic and normocytic, the variation in distribution of their width of distributive curve has been widened. Here the width of distributive curve is less. Is that right? When RBCs vary in size from each other, we say there is an isocytosis. What is there? An isocytosis. Iso mean same. Isocytosis means same size. An isocytosis mean RBCs are not having the same size. So if someone has this very wide, it means some RBCs are very small and some are very large. So we say he is having which problem? An isocytosis. Or simply in modern terms, we say patient has increased red cell distributive width. Because these new automated counters, when you put the patient blood and automatically machine counts the red cell number, red cell size, red cell per hemoglobin, so many results machine generates. Modern machines also generate this curve concept. If your RBCs, most of the RBCs are very near to the same size, curve will have small width. If most of the RBCs, but RBCs are varying too much, curve will become wide. And really it becomes too wide when you have two different types of RBCs population with different sizes. You may have microcytic and normocytic. If you have come across another patient, sometimes you come across another patient, he has microcytic going down, then this curve disappear. This is on average 60 and this is on average 120. What is his problem? He has double RBCs, some RBCs with 60 femtoliter average and some are 120. He has microcytic and macrocytic. Some RBCs are too small. There's a full group of RBCs which are too small. The full group of RBCs are too large. Such are, again, what is there? Increased width of? Yes, what? Red cell distributive width has been increased. Right? Or we say that he has polymorphic RBCs. Polymorphic or dimorphic RBC. Morpho means shape, size, and dimorphic. This type of situation can be seen when you have double anemia. For example, a patient who has iron deficiency anemia as well as B12 deficiency anemia. Iron deficiency anemia make the RBCs which are very microcytic, and B12 deficiency make the RBCs which are very large. So in this patient, what will happen? There will be microcytosis as well as there will be macrocytosis, and distributive widths will be very wide. Is this concept clear? No problem here. So can you talk about all these terms in an intelligent way? Okay, class dismissed.